जाति से लेकर के हर चीज और आर्थिक चीज को भी इसमें जो है जोड़ा जा रहा है, और इससे हम लोगों के पास सही साइंटिफिक डेटा होगा तो हम लोग उसी हिसाब से बजट का स्वरूप बनेगा, उसी हिसाब से कल्याणकारी योजनाएं बनेंगी।
द मच टॉक्ड अबाउट कास्ट सेंसस हैज बिगन इन द स्टेट ऑफ बिहार टुडे, दैट इज ऑन 7th January. द फर्स्ट फेज ऑफ द सेंसस विल कल्मिनेट ऑन January 21st, व्हाइल द सेकंड फेज विल स्टार्ट ऑन द 1st ऑफ अप्रैल दिस ईयर. A total amount of ₹500 crore will be spent on the exercise. In the first phase of the caste census, the number of all households in the state will be counted. In the second phase, starting from March, data pertaining to people of all castes, subcastes and religions will be collected. Enumerators, whose training began on December 15th, will also record information about the financial status of all the people. Data will be collected from the panchayat to the district level digitally via a mobile application. The application will have questions about place, caste, number of people in a family, their profession and annual income. Census workers include teachers, Anganwadi, MG Narega or Jivika workers. Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar on Friday said that the purpose of the exercise is to carry out developmental work for the people who are deprived. The caste-based headcount will be beneficial for all. It will enable the government to work for the development of various sections of the society, including those who are deprived. After completion of the enumeration exercise, the final report will be sent to center also. Kumar said while interacting with the reporters on the second day of his Samadhan Yatra in Shivhar district. Caste-based count has been a major issue in Bihar politics, with Nitish Kumar's JDU and all constituents of the Mahagathbandhan long being demanding that the exercise be undertaken at the earliest. The Congress-led UPA government at the centre had agreed to conduct the exercise at the national level in 2010, but the data collected during the census were never processed. Caste as an entity plays a major role in Indian politics. However, the advocates of the caste-based census argue that the reservation to the SCs and STs was given based on their population, but this is not the case with the OBCs. The Congress-led UPA government conducted the socio-economic and caste census in 2011, but the data was not released. Bihar has been repeatedly demanding a caste census for the last several years. The State Legislative Assembly passed two unanimous resolutions in 2018 and 2019 in favour of a caste census. Last year in June, an all-party meeting in Bihar, chaired by CM Nitish Kumar, unanimously gave its go-ahead. If the caste census data comes out before the 2024 Lok Sabha election, Nitish and his deputy CM Tejaswi Yadav, both heading caste-based parties, could be its biggest beneficiaries. Conversely, the sensitive caste census data may ignite a fresh rounds of mandal and kamandal politics. A caste census is basically the counting of people belonging to different castes in a particular marked area. With this two-phase exercise, the state government will try to get number of people belonging to the SC, ST and OBC communities and their financial status, among other important things. Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar said, the exercise is basically Jati Adharit Ganana. People belonging to every religion and caste will be covered during the exercise.